Hi everyone, it's Chris, and I'm here to do a textured background, and what I'm using mine for is a canvas. And this is the canvas with the textured background. This is my end result. I chose this canvas from an old picture that I got at Goodwill, but I don't have another one, so I'm just going to show you on some 6x6 chipboard, which I used the gloss super heavy gel to do my texture. But the first process you need to do is pick out your background color and then choose, these ones are the Perfect Pearls Glimmer Mist. So I chose a Sunflower Sparkle and the Interference Red. And I've learned that every background does not turn out the same. So I'm just going to tell you and show you here what I did to make the background of the canvas that I made. You could also use Mod Podge for making a textured background, as long as you stiffle the Mod Podge to make the texture. Now the one I used, like I said, was this one. It's a lot thicker. And that's what I used on this. And then I used this yellow background paint. And after showing you the process, you'll see how the textured background looks, which I will give you a close-up. And I made this for a friend. I have to be honest, I had a different tutorial planned, but it wasn't working. So I tried for a couple hours and it didn't work. So I had to go on to my next project, which is the textured background for a canvas, or you could use it on a 6x6 mini. I mean, pretty much anything, you can do it on a tag, anything you want. But you can get a lot of different effects while using the different text background. No, I have noticed that no canvas turns out exactly the same, which is kind of fun. So we're going to add the yellow. And I put a pretty good coat on it. You don't need to make it real, real thick, just so you have a real good even coat on your canvas or your chipboard. And in between drying times, I will step off for a minute, dry everything, and then come back and start the next process. Next month's tutorial is going to be more planned out. The tutorial I was planning on, it just would not turn out to where I liked it. So I know that everybody pretty much has paint, and you can use any kind of background or medium. You can add a little bit of flour or sand to your Mod Podge so that it gives it a more heightened texture on here. So that's about all the paint I want on there. So I'm going to go ahead and dry this. I'll be right back and we'll start the texture. Okay, so while that's dry, so it's just got the yellow paint on it, I'm going to start applying my texture. Now, like I said, this is a gloss super heavy gel, which you can see it's real chunky, or you know, heavy. So what I started doing on my sides and just the edges. I'm kind of stippling the heavy gel so I can get a nice texture on there. Now in the middle, what I did was I just took my paintbrush and kind of went every direction, kind of leaving a brush effect on the middle. And my sides, I just, like I said, I have kind of the stippling effect. And you can make it as thick or as thin as you'd like. The stuff just works fabulous. I really love the effect that it gives after it dries. So as you can see, I'm just adding my stippling effects to the edges and the corners. And then again, I'm going to brush on towards the middle. Now, before this is dry, what I did was I took my Perfect Pearls Glimmer Mist, which I'm using Sunflower Sparkle and Inferior Red. And I'm just gonna go ahead and add my color to it. Wouldn't you know, they're clogged. Okay, I'll be right back so I can unclog these.